clear cleanly. Flying camel, now watch him tap and jump over. Obviously taking his time here at the beginning of the program, not rushing right into a 5-minute program, but beginning slowly. And here at triple, let's jump. 3 revolutions. That was a great one. Now for once, he seems to be on the road. He's gotten those 3 triple jumps over with. A smile for the first time has come on in his face. Now he seems to be back to the old Terry Kubicka.
And to think he's only been skating for 9 years, Dick. That's something?
That's right, Chris. And incidentally, the marks for David Santee range 5'6" and 5'7". There he is, back.
He's having fun.
This is a boy who gets the audience going. Look at these combination wallies.
The world arena, the audience enjoying the performance of Terry Kubicka of Cypress, California, battling for a spot on the United States Olympic team.
Another triple toe jump planned here. Triple toe loop. Flying camel, now watch him drop this position.
Third, coming into the final 5-minute performance, third after the compulsories, behind David Santee and Charles Tickner, only 2 are chosen for the Olympic team.
Watch him take this up into a jump. Here it is. Triple Salchow. Young man who skates with enormous confidence. With a great feeling of security that he's not going to miss his jump. Watch this flying open axle sit spin. Look at that.
Final minute of his performance.
And a pair of double axles here for 1.5 revolution. Return. He elected only to do 1. He has, incidentally, coming up a plan, and I don't know if he's going to do it or not. It's a backflip, a move that's been done in show skating for a long period of time, but not an amateur competition, a very acrobatic move. Got it scheduled here. Axle. Got it scheduled here coming. He does not have to do it. He can elect not to. But if he can do it, yeah, here it comes. Right here. And a flying sit spin at the end. Watch him pull this audience to his feet already. He's not even finished. With the 6 Arabians coming up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And a final stretch spin. Young man who pulled every acrobatic trick out of the hat to get this audience standing on its feet.
The most spontaneous reaction to any of the skaters here in the 1976 United States Championships. Terry Kubicka, and what a smile. What a performance.
Coach there, Evie Scott Bold. Here is slow motion now on that flip that he does. A move we've seen often in shows, but not in competition. Watch him now step the right foot back into a toe lift, lift himself up, over, and come down. Fairly poor landing, but nevertheless a completed move. Here are the second set of marks now for Terry Kubicka. The first set, 5-7, 5-8, and 1-5-9. These, you can see, are 5-9, 5-8, but except for judge number 7, which is a 5-5. Now, he is perfectly justified in giving that mark. It is only in comparison to the other skaters. That judge is just being questioned by the man in the center, who is the president of the United States Figure Skating Association, Mr. Benjamin Wright. They are questioning him as to why his mark is that low. The judge, the gray hair, Mr. Zaps, Matthew Zaps. Now, I'm suspecting that what he is doing is defending his mark on the basis of the fact that he doesn't feel that it was done with great style. It was an artistic content that he had to put, that the second mark stood for, and that's why he marked him down. The judges are now conferring. If that judge can defend his position accurately, the mark will stand. I believe the mark will stand on any condition, but he has to defend his mark at that point.
A 5-5, 4-5-9s, and 2-5-8s. We'll be back in just a minute to see if there is any change.
Point 5 of Judge Matthew Zapp stands as it must under the